Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be making a 3D model of this cube in a cube in Sketchup. So on Discord that I'm a part of, there were some people trying to figure out this math question by using Sketchup to model this sort of odd shape. So I figured I would take a stab at it myself. Okay, so we have SketchUp open here, and I've deleted our scale figure. And from our question, there is a 4x4x4 cube and a 3x3x3 cube, and then they're sort of slightly offset. I won't go into the details of exactly what that looks like right now, but we'll jump into that a little bit later. So I just typed in 4, 4 for that, and then I'm going to hit P to push-pull that, and then 4 as well to make this cube. I'm going to make that a group. Make another rectangle. 3x3, and then up 3, double click this, make group. Okay, now what I'm going to do on this is, I'm going to make a 3x3, that's basically the top of this shape here, and then come across. And then what I want to do is I just want to make a cross here, up, same distance, just going up. I just want to get a plane that'll help me get my shape in the right spot. So if you look at this shape here, you can see that I don't know the exact angle that this is, but there's a point here. These are equidistant, these three lines, but there's these three points touching as well. So at first when I was trying to do this, I just put this box here and I was like, it's equidistant, got it. But it's actually rotated a little bit. So actually, it's sort of like, I think it is like this. But this sort of like swings up and out. So what you do, I made this plane here so that I can rotate it out. So what I'm gonna do is just rotate this until I get this little corner, and then go back to this point here, making sure that I am on this plane and hitting shift, that way I stay there. And then I can select this point down here and go until we intersect. I'm having a little bit of trouble here, which isn't necessarily a problem. What I can do is draw a circle and connect it with that point, because this is just a really nice circle, and then that'll give you my intersect point. So again, Q, select this shape, and now I have that intersection point. And with very little work, we were able to get that shape. So pretty cool. Now, as a bonus for sticking around to the end of this, you can really quickly actually get the inverse of this, and I'm curious to see just what it looks like. So if you have the solid tools set up, if you right-click in an open space, in a white space, there's solid tools, and that'll bring you this toolbar. If you look at the subtract, it'll subtract the first solid from the second. So if I select this, then my second, I get this shape. Now I have this other extra thing, but basically it gives you this cool little diamond thing. Anyway, if you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.